one of the challenges we're having this year, particularly that's difficult, is the increased number of tourism or tourists that are coming down. Previously, this time of year, November, December, January, February, was always the peak season for tourist visits at Shuizhou. What has happened different this year from previous years is that the e-visa and the easier access visas for mainland Chinese visitors has brought us a 4 to 5-fold increase in tourists here at Shuizhou. So for the very first peak season, we are now having extremely high numbers of tourists visiting the site. This is putting a lot of stress and strain on the building while we're doing conservation work. And one of the major concerns we have is with visitors smoking cigarettes, touching parts of the building, climbing on parts of the building. In the previous past, there had been a security presence here through the tourism police, but since 2015, that doesn't exist. And this issue is put on 2 to 3 cleaning ladies from the Department of Antiquities, who are strained in the activities they must do, normally with their cleaning and maintenance, but also with security. It's a very big concern, as you would imagine, for a building such as Shuizhou here, when you have people smoking cigarettes inside the building. From an aspect of an organization who's doing conservation, and that's our focus, it's difficult for us as well to always follow this through. It's very important that Mandalay Regional Government address this issue and find the means to bring a security presence here during this busy tourist season. So if I could ask any wish right now, it would be that the local government would step up and put some security here to help protect this building. We're very happy that we received our third Ambassador's Fund for Cultural Preservation grant. That current grant that we've received is to cover a number of activities. One is the completion of the north veranda, so to bring the veranda all the way around. Second is that a lot of pieces are missing from the building. For instance, what you see behind me, most of this was built in the 1980s and 90s. Very little of what you see on the exterior is original to Konbon. But it's important that when new pieces replace old pieces, that they follow a Konbon stylistic and techniques. Because a building like this is built in a monsoon environment, it will decay, it will rot, it will disappear. But it's important that you reinvest in the building in a way that's consistent with preserving its Konbon integrity. The third thing we're going to do is we're going to finish the set of staircases. The masonry staircases that go around the building need to have intervention. We've worked on one, we're going to finish the rest of them under this funding. And then we're going to do something that you might hear some noises behind us running occasionally, saws, and that is a termite extermination program. So we have employed Green Pest Control from Yangon to work with us for 1 year to eliminate and eradicate termites, and then to install an annual termite treatment program to protect the building from insect invasion. And the last thing we're going to be doing with this money is a number of new proposals and studies to support going after additional funding to cover a number of topics. For instance, one will be documentation to produce the reports that allow us to fix the roof, which would be a new funding proposal we would make after the current funding. Two, we want to develop new bathrooms. So we're doing the designs to an architect, Uong So Mint in Yangon. He's designing new bathrooms for the site, and we will propose those to Mandalay Regional Government. Three, we're talking with the U.S. Embassy and the Ministry of Culture about developing a visitor's center that would be in the garden south of Shuizhou for visitors to understand the importance and history of the building, as well as the ongoing conservation work.
Okay. 65တုန်းကဦးတို့ဒီဘာတွေစိတ်တောင်းနေဘာတွေပြင်ခဲရတုန်းကလည်းရေနံကြီးတီလိုပဲတုတ်ခဲတာပဲလာပြီးပြီးတော့ရေနံကြီးတုတ်အခုသူတို့လည်းရေနံတုတ်နေတာပဲတွေ့တယ်ပေါ့နော်ဘာกว่าလဲရေနံတုတ်တဲ့ပုံစံနေကြတော့အဲ့ဒါ
ရေနံတုတ်တဲ့ပုံစံကတော့ရေနံကြီးဆိုတော့ဒီမိုးရေဘာတွေမဟုတ်ဘူးပေါ့နော်မိုးရေရှော့ကြတာပေါ့နော်နောက်ချက်တော့သူချရပဲမလာဘူးပေါ့ဒီနေ့တော့နှချဝင်တာသူချရတော့တတ်နေကြပါဟုတ
်ကဲ့
သူတို့လောက်တာကချက်လို့အခုချတတ်တယ်ပါလာကိုယ်ကချတတ်တာမပါရဘူးဟုတ်ကဲ့ဟု
တ်ကဲ့ဥရောအနေနဲ့သူတို့စီကရောပညာပြန်ရတာတွေရောဘာတွေရှိလဲဘာပညာရတာရှိလဲ
ဟိုအတွေ့အကြုံတွေတော်တော်များများရပါတယ်နိုင်ငံရဲ့ပညာရှင်တွေပါတယ်လေဂျာမနီရဲ့ဒီပါတယ်နောက်ဥတလီရဲ့ပါတယ်နောက်ဂျမိုရီရဲ့ပါတယ်ထိုင်းပါတယ်ပညာရှင်ပေါင်းစုပေါင်းနေရတာဆိုတော့ဘုဒ္ဓရာတွေအများကြီးရပါတယ်ခေါင်းလည်းကောင်းပါတယ်